Devin won.
Ow.
Be close though.
They no, don't... it wasn't. He demolished me the last second. Ow.
What is going on out there to all the gamers, video enthusiasts, and YouTubers? I am the one, only, and truly Jake the Snake. Back with another vlog. This is going to be part 3 of the Building the Arena vlog with Chip. And I'm having a new friend join us today, and he's going to help us and maybe plink around with us. The only reason I started this vlog at my house is because I'm waiting for this delicious thing to be done, which it is. It's like biscuits. I don't know how well you can see that, but it's like microwavable biscuits, and they're pretty good. So I'm gonna eat those and then head over to Chip's house probably. So I don't know how much you guys remember of my last vlog, but my last vlog, I completely destroyed my gun pretty much. Like, the scope was broken, the foregrip was broke, and there's like an extended part right here, like an extended barrel, that part broke. And I managed to somehow fix the scope, which is awesome. Because the scope is kind of a big deal, a part of this gun. And I don't think I'll ever be able to fix the foregrip, nor the barrel. But if I could just fix this part, which is what I'm working on right now, that'd be awesome. And then right now, I'm trying to add this tactical sling on here, which would make it a billion times easier to reload, which would be double awesome for me. So I'm going to work on that for a little while. And then I think I'm going to head over to the Chip's after I finished working on this. Alright, so I finally got the tactical sling attached. I'm pretty sure this isn't how you do it, but I did it for myself, and I'm proud of it. So I got a red dot sight, and I got a tactical sling, which is awesome. I might be able to install the foregrip on later, but at the moment, I really don't need it. So I think now I'm going to head over to Chip's house, and yeah, I'll see you there. Alright, we're back at Chip's casa, aka house if you don't know Spanish. It's pretty early in the morning, but there's no rest for the legendary for Airsoft. Chip has a bunch of .12 ammo. I think we're going to plink around for a little while because it's kind of worthless in wars. So we're just going to plink around with our guns, and I'm going to try to get mine zeroed in if that's possible. So yeah, we're just waiting until our friend shows up, and then we can get some things started. Jesus, Jeff, don't shoot on my camera.
Place the spawn for the defender for objective spot.
Yeah, we built this a long, long time ago in like Boy Scouts, and we just left it here. I knew it'd make some good use someday.
Like a barracks, like a pallet right there.
Whoa, y'all actually use the knot?
Yeah.
Everyone? Yeah, I remember having to use that.
So this is like pretty much the lower ground. I have 3 different grounds. So there's red tape up there.
Alright, so we're about to begin our first ever airsoft war. Devin, you might remember him from the camping trip I did a while back. He was in there. And we're going to do an airsoft war now. I think it's going to be me and Devin up first. Devin doesn't have an electric rifle, so I don't know how that'll affect my competition. But it should be alright. My FAMAS should be able to handle.
Alright guys, what is going on? It's Chip back with Devin. So I'll be spectating, and I'll be recording Jake and Devin fight. And to keep it fair, I have no weapons on me except for a pistol. And so yeah, this should be interesting.
You ready, Devin?
Yep.
Devin be starting down in the defender spawn, and Jake is currently walking back to the attacker spawn, and then they'll meet in the middle and then just go to whoever dies. The rules: one shot to the chest or head, you're out, but 2 shots to the arm or leg. Got it?
All right
I'll yell when we're ready. All right Jake, remember, 1 shot to the head or chest, you're dead. 2 shots to the arm or leg, you're dead. Got it?
So 1 shot head, dead?
Yeah.
And 2 anywhere else, you're dead?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so from last time we made a video out here, we haven't really put up much barricades. We reinforced some so babies don't go through them. I actually found about 13 or 15 more pallets that we need for free from a neighbor. So that was pretty awesome. We'll get those in a little bit. But we wanted to fight a little bit. So Jake, you're gonna keep walking down.
I'm gonna go down all the way over there
to the attacker spawn. And Jake, holler when you're ready. Now yell to Devin to fight.
Mask on! You ready?
Devin, you ready?
Ready!
Alright, let's go! Jake just fell. You can see there's Devin down there. Walking through the woods. Here comes Jake. I'm gonna get out of the way so I don't get shot. Do something. Jake's up there around that cover right there, that orange, shooting at Devin.
Does that count as one? Hit you in the leg?
Yeah, got one more. Alright, so Devin's been hit once in the leg, so there's one more shot and then he's dead. Alright, so both of them are hitting the leg once. It's pretty close. Jake's behind that tree right there. Devin's right there. Kind of taking some blind shots right now. It's pretty close. Close quarter, there goes Jake. Right there, moving up. Devin's taking cover over there.
I'm done.
Alright, Jake is the hit. Alright.
I forgot you could do that.
Alright, so Devin won.
Ow.
Pretty close though.
They it wasn't. He demolished me the last second. Ow. Shot me like three times in the back.
Yeah, you didn't see the.
No, I forgot you. Guy. I forgot you could stick your. Like, I can't stick my barrel through there. But I saw that orange tip. I was like.
Alright, so it's up to the last like 3 seconds, it was pretty close. They both had one hit on each other. It's pretty good. Jake's in a lot of pain right now.
Yeah, because I got shot like 5 times in the back. I didn't even pull out my pistol yet.
Anyway, so yeah. Y'all want to go again?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
God. I say y'all go again because that was pretty close.
Until the last second.
I was going easy on you.
Shut up. Where are you?
So are we going again, boys?
Huh?
So are we going again?
Yep.
1v1? Alright, so I'll be more spectating. Sorry guys if this is like the worst quality video you ever got. I'm not a professional, unlike Jake, so... But I'm gonna do what I can do. Jake found his speed loader and all this crap he needs now, so that's good. So they can go at it again. And then a little bit later, we'll do a 2v1. Obviously Devin will be by himself because he has this fully auto rifle. Me and Jake are stuck with spring-loaded and pump-action shotguns. But it'd be interesting. I'm excited about it. Alright, Jake, you go down there by the fence.
I'm not even fair.
Alright, Devin, I'll show you where the attacker spawn is. The reason why we put the attacker spawn down there, guys, is because right here, going all the way up this hill, it's one big hill you can't really see on the camera, but it's one gigantic ass hill. We captured the flag, and so the attacker's gonna have to work up the hill to get the flag. Jake, you ready?
Yeah.
Devin, ready?
Yeah.
Alright, let's go. There's something. Jake's being pretty aggressive. Coming up over there. There he is. Devin's making his way up the hill. Here comes Jake. We back up some. Jake's very, very close. Jake's behind a pallet right now. Taking cover. Here comes Devin. Should I get some shots on Devin? Devin's still towards the bottom of the hill. And there's Jake.
See, they're getting pretty close to each other again. There's Devin, Jake. Jake's making a run for it. Devin's kind of puts it behind a tree. Devin just unloaded like half his magazine, tried to pin Jake down. Alright, Jake's falling back. Alright. Devin got a headshot on Jake.
Ow! I got hit in the head! Like the actual back pin of my head.
Alright, Devin is totally.
There's one thing I can learn from this ring is worthless against. Like, not even compatible. Because if I'm within 50 feet of him, I can't move.
Alright, so Jake got hit in the back of the head, dead skin.
It's not even compatible.
I'll do a single action next time.
Doesn't matter. Still, yeah. You have to wait at least 2 seconds in between my shots.
Devin, oh shit. Devin to do semi-auto instead of full auto.
Still kick my ass. Whatever.
I'm pretty proud of myself though, because this barricade right here deflected a lot of BBs.
I know it did. Honestly, the sticky barricade actually did halfway decent.
I did. Good job on that. Or else I'll come shoot you in the back of the head with my pistol in my pocket.
He's raging. Right,
so I'm gonna walk up Devin to the spawn. Alright, I'll see y'all back in a couple minutes. Alright, so Jake got shot up pretty bad. They're redoing it again though, one more round. And then we're probably gonna pick up some pallets, get some lunch going, because it is almost 12. And we only have about three or four more hours. Yeah, we won't be able to do this much longer. And the attacker spawned. Devin's gonna stay on semi-auto only and not full auto. Jake actually had one more hit on Devin the last round, and Devin would have been out because Devin got shot in the leg and the ricochet off the arm.
I didn't know I hit him.
Yeah, you hit him. He got hit by ricochet, but I'm not gonna count that one. Anyway, but he got shot in the leg. Devin, you ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Let's go. I'm gonna try to be more closer to the players. Hopefully, not get shot by Devin. There's Devin. Alright, so there's Jake behind a tree trying to snipe Devin. I actually fell just now. So that's why I'm on the ground. They're right here. There's Devin blind firing. Somewhat. Jake behind the tree. Jake's taking more of a sniper position up behind a tree. In the arm?
Yeah.
Alright, keep flying.
Ow! I'm done. I don't think I got 10 shots off. No, it's just not fair, because we can pin you down with that semi-automatic thing.
Well, I think it'd be better once me and you go at him next.
Well, yeah. The problem is, if he's locked on you, you can't move. Because no matter what, even with semi-automatic, that's fast enough where I can keep you pinned. I don't think I got 10 shots off that time.
You can't pin down two people.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying.
I gotta go back and reload.
But as you can see down here, we have got all the pallets from our neighbor. And then we are going back inside to get some pizza and just chill, because we have had a very long day already. I've been shot like 5 times. And yeah.
Talk to you again.
Hey, Jeremy, I'm gonna show you my our awesome 3v5 comeback.
Oh yeah, show us your Rainbow 5 footage, Chip.
Yo, Rainbow
6 Siege, okay?
Jeez. 6.
Dude, I haven't played that before. Is it good?
Yeah,
it's really fun, but you gotta have multiplayer though.
Inside, they don't know I'm in this corner, right?
Yeah.
And so I'm hiding in this corner. And then I decided to wait, this isn't a really good spot.
We need to protect the biohazard container. Secure the room.
I've gotten 2.5 hours.
Bruh, Chip got kicked off the Rainbow Six Siege servers for team killing, so now we have nothing to do for half an hour.
We can go outside. What?
Very disappointing.
I know, it's very disappointing indeed, Chip. We thought you were better than this.
Might be. They were annoying, so I killed them.
Chip ran up, and then put my mag in, and I put 20 rounds in him.
Didn't Chip? You shot Chip like 20 times?
Just
no,
about.
He shot me twice, and both of them were ricocheted.
No, at the end.
Just those two.
Ouch.
That's it. That's really what I felt anyway.
When I came around the corner, I couldn't see y'all, or see you, Chip, when you came around.
Chip.
What?
Did you have fun?
Yeah, I had fun.
Yeah, it was really fun.
This is actually me and Chip's first time we've actually played with each other, with another person. For the longest time, me and him just plinked around together, but actually competing with someone else, so three people, was pretty interesting. Devin actually had an automatic rifle, which made it kind of unfair at some points, because he's like, it was so unfair, he could like spray automatic fire everywhere, and it made it completely impossible sometimes, but when me and Chip went against him, I think we got him halfway decently, but yeah, that's pretty much it. I think we're all gonna head home soon. We're all pretty tired and worn out. We're running around, dodging each other's BBs. It can be tiring.
Yeah, ride along.
Yeah, and Chip mainly, the only mainly reason me and Devin are leaving because Chip has a ride along at 3 o'clock, and I want to get home before that. But yeah, we all had really a lot of fun today. Glad Devin came along and helped us move the pallets, because that was a really big project that we needed to take care of. So yeah, till next time.